chapter 6, triangles part 9. So we will see some more problems from exercise 6.4. The fourth problem is very, very important. If the areas of two similar triangles are equal, prove that they are congruent. They are congruent. So two triangles you take, ABC, PQR, both are similar, it is given, and the area equal. Then you have to prove two triangles are congruent. Okay. So this is a very important question, because similar triangle is given, you have to prove congruent. Okay. How to prove? That is very important. See the proof. First you take the given triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR given. Immediately you can use the result that by theorem. When the two triangles are similar, then you can write area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB squared by PQ squared is equal to BC squared by QR squared and AC squared by PR squared. So this result you have to remember always. Okay. But area equal given, but area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle PQR. It is given. It is also given. Area of triangle PQR is also given. Therefore, in place of triangle ABC, you can put PQR, area of triangle PQR. Therefore, area of triangle PQR divided by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB squared by PQ squared is equal to BC squared by QR squared is equal to AC squared by PR. Okay, so now both numerator denominator same means what? You cancel means 1 this way. Clear? Now what I am going to do is this 1 you take. 1 equal to AB squared by PQ squared. Okay, first 2 you take. That is 1 is equal to first 1 you take. Okay. Now when you cross multiply, therefore this implies what? AB squared equal to PQ squared. Therefore, square root on both sides means AB equal to PQ. AB equal to PQ. You take 1. Similarly, you take 1 equal to this means BC equal to QR. Same way you do. That is 2. And AC squared. And AC squared by PR squared equal to 1 means AC is equal to PR. AC is equal to PR. That is 3. Understand? Okay. Now what you have to do is you take these two triangles. You take these two triangles in triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Triangle PQR. So now you apply these three, that is AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR, AC equal to PR. Here you can write reason by 1, by 2, by 3. This implies Therefore, tripulous congruency. Okay, tripulous congruency rule, that is
Yes. That is side. Reveal us onto one's own. These two triangles are congruent. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Hence, congruent. Hence, proof. Okay. So, similar triangle is given. You have to use that area, ratio of the area of two triangles. The theorem result you have to use, and you have to easily prove by using trivialous congruence rule and two triangles are congruent. Okay. So, very important problem. Okay. Thoroughly practice. So, you see this problem, fifth problem, D, E, F are respectively midpoints of the sides BC, CA, AB of triangle ABC. Determine the ratio of the areas of the two triangles. So, in a triangle ABC, you take the midpoint, correctly midpoint, D, E, F are the midpoints of BC, AC and the AB. Then you join the midpoints. So, means you will get how many triangles? 1, 2, 3, 4 triangles inside the triangle ABC. So, all the 4 triangles are congruent to each other. Congruent to each other. How to prove? Then the whole area of triangle ABC is nothing but 4 times of the area of triangle DEF. All 4 triangles. Clear? So that means each triangle, that small triangle, each triangle is 1/4 of the area of triangle ABC. That means you will get the ratio 1:4. Okay, you have to prove. So how to prove these all the triangles are congruent to each other? So how to prove? By using a congruence rule, easily we can prove it. Okay. So when the two triangles are congruent, then area will be clear. All the congruent triangles area will be equal. Clear. So given ABC is a triangle, DEF are midpoints of BC, AC and AB respectively. How to find out the ratio? How to find out the ratio? So solution you have to write. Okay. How to find out the solution? Sometime what they may ask. To prove 1:4. 1:4. Good. Now in triangle ABC, you take these two points, that is E and F are midpoints. In triangle ABC, E and F are midpoints given. It is given. So by midpoint theorem, ninth class also you have studied. Okay, in a triangle, two midpoint is parallel to the third side. That means FE parallel to BC. FE parallel to BC and FE is half of BC. Okay, FE is half of BC. These two parallel and half of BC. Okay. Now BD also what? Half of BC. That is given. Here. But BD is half of BC. Okay, given. So what will happen? Opposite sides are parallel and equal. Opposite sides are parallel and equal. Clear? FE is half of BC. BD is also half of BC. Because D is midpoint. D is midpoint. It is given. Therefore, it is parallelogram. When the opposite, one pair of opposite sides or parallel and equal, then we can say BD EF is a parallel line. This implies BD EF is a parallel line. BDEF is a parallelogram. Clear? When it is parallelogram, then other parallels will be equal. That is, FB equal to ED. FB equal to ED. Therefore, FB equal to ED. That is opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposites of parallelogram. Okay. This one you take it as 1. Similarly, we can prove what this also parallelogram. This also parallelogram. We can prove. Okay. Then in 9th class we have studied one result. In a parallelogram, the diagonal divide the two triangles in congruent. Clear? Two triangles in congruent. And they are equal in area. They are equal in area. You can use that method also. Clear? Or better use triangle. You take this triangle, two congruent. FBD. Triangle. FBD and triangle DEF. Take DEF. DEF. FB equal to ED. FB equal to what? ED. Okay. Because opposite sides of a parallel. Opposites of the parallel, that is, we proved it. Okay, FB equal to ED by 1. Next, you see FD equal to FD. Common. Then FE equal to BD. FE equal to BD. Here, FE equal to BD. Clear? Opposites of your parallelogram. Or BD equal to FE. That is better. Okay. That is opposites of parallelogram. Opposites of parallelogram. Therefore, by tripleless congruency rule, right? Tripleless congruency rule. Two triangles congruent. Triangle FBD is congruent to triangle DEF. Okay. When the two triangles are congruent, then area will be equal. Therefore, area of what? FBD is equal to area of BEF. This is 2 you did. This is 2. Similarly, you take these two triangles also congruent. Therefore, area will be equal. Because this is parallelogram. This is parallelogram. So, diagonal divides the two triangles in congruent and they are in equal area. Therefore,
same
D area of triangle DEF equal to area of triangle EDC. This is 3. Now you take this parallelogram. This parallelogram you take. Okay, this diagonal divide two triangles in contour one, same way, contour one. So area will be equal. Again, area of triangle DEF is equal to area of triangle to AF. What I am going to do is area of triangle ABC. How will you write area of triangle ABC equal to area of triangle AFE plus area of triangle FBD plus area of triangle DEF plus area of triangle ADC. Four triangles, this whole triangle area you can split into four triangles, split into four triangles. But four triangles area will be equal. Therefore, what we can do is this area is nothing but DEF. Use 1, 2, 3 or 2, 3, 4. Use 2, 3, 4. See AFE, nothing but area of DEF. You could replace it. Area of DEF. Plus same way FBD also area of triangle DEF. Already you have area of DEF, right, as it is. Plus this is also nothing but area of DEF. Okay, here you write by 2, 3, 4. So, this is nothing but 4 times of area of DEF. Okay. 1 plus 2 plus 3, 4. 4 times. Here. Therefore, we need this one. Here. Area of DEF is equal to this 4. You divide this side. The same thing can be written as, okay, 1 by 4. Or area of ABC, 1 by 4 of area of ABC. Therefore, area of DEF is to area of ABC equal to 1 is to 4. You divide this one, this side means you will get area of DEF is to area of ABC equal to 1 is to. Understand? So this result is very, very important. In one mark also, MCQ type, straight away they will ask. So you have to remember, clear? This problem, one mark also they will ask. So you have to remember this. So 1 is to 4, standard questions. Always remember. Blindly you can write 1 is to 4. Okay? When the midpoints are given in a triangle, clear? Line joining midpoint is always parallel to the third side and half of it by using midpoint theorem. You have to remember that result. Using that result, you can easily prove two triangles are congruent. Then all the four triangles congruent to each other. Okay, using this result, easily we can bring 1:4 is the required ratio. Okay, next problem we will see, the sixth problem. Prove that the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of the corresponding median. So median means you take the midpoint and join opposite vertex, means you will get median. So here AL is the median and here PM is the median. So this AL is median means L is midpoint. So these two sides are equal. That is BL equal to what? LC. Same way here. PM is median means PM is midpoint. Midpoint means what? Both will be equal. Similar triangle is given. Similar triangle is given. Okay. Similar triangle means all the corresponding angles are equal and all the corresponding sides are proportional. Clear? So using that, easily we can prove these two triangles are similar. That is ABL and PQM. Similar means you can corresponding sides are proportional. That is AL by PM equal to AB by PQ. You can write. So first you take a similar triangle, that is AB, triangle ABC, similar to triangle PQR. Triangle PQR. Therefore, corresponding angles are proportional. You take a necessary angle, that is angle B equal to angle Q, that we need clear. Angle B equal to angle Q and corresponding sides are proportional. You take this side, AB by PQ. Equal to BC by QR. BC by QR. Okay. Even you can write AC by PR also. That is not necessary. Okay. No need to take. Now, BC by QR, you can write it as here BC is nothing but 2BL. 2BL. Because BC nothing but BL plus. LC. LC nothing but BL. So, 2BL you can write. Therefore, this can be written as AB by PQ is equal to 2BL by 2QM. 2QM. So, 2 cut it. Therefore, AB equal to PQ, that is equal to BL equal to QM. BL equal to QM. Understand? Now you take these two triangles. That is in triangle. Take this is 1, this is 2. Okay. So in triangle ABL and triangle PQM. Angle B equal to angle Q by 1 and AB by PQ equal to BL by QM by 2. Understand? So this B and Q are included angles. These two triangles included angle. Therefore, we can use by SAS similarity. Therefore, by SAS similarity, these two triangles are similar. Triangle ABL similar to triangle PQM. Similar. Therefore, sides are proportional. Sides are proportional. AB by PQ equal to AL by PM. AL by PM. AL by PM. This one you take it as 3. And you take it as 3. Okay. But what we have to prove? Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQ are equal to AL square by PM square. AL square by PM square. We have to prove. Right. So, further what you have to do is, when the two triangles are similar, use the ratio of the area of two similar triangles theorem. Clear? So, here, but triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR given
therefore by theorem, or by theorem, area of triangle ABC by is equal to AB by P, AB squared by PQ squared, AB squared by PQ squared. Okay, AB squared by PQ squared. Now using this 3, that is in place of AB by PQ, you can replace it here. Or this this one you can write whole squared. This one you can write it as what, whole squared. Okay, both are same. Whole squared also you can. You using 3, you replace it. Triangle ABC by area of PQR is equal to AL by PM, the whole squared. You write by 3. By 3. So this is also written as AL squared by PM squared. Hence proved. Okay, so easily you can do this. You see, this seventh problem is very, very important. In exercise 6.4, seventh problem is repeated questions. Clear? Prove that the areas of the equilateral triangle described on the side of a square is of the area of the equilateral triangle described on its diagonal. You take the square, ABCD is a square. First, what you take the side, you take the side. Okay. Same length, take the same length and you have to describe one equilateral triangle. Okay. Then you take diagonal, you take any one diagonal, BD is a diagonal, same length, you take it and describe one equilateral triangle. So now what you have to prove is this area is half of this area of equilateral triangle. That is you have to prove. Okay. So how to prove this? Proof. What is the diagonal of a square? First, find out diagonal of a square. Use the Pythagoras theorem. Here, this is 90 degree means use this Pythagoras theorem. Because you know this base BC. Here, you take this is A, side A. Side A you take. Okay. Side A you take. So you know the base of this side is A. Here base you should know, this base you should know. That's why for diagonal you have to find out. So use Pythagoras theorem. Clear? So first you write ABCD is a square. Given. Square means all sides are equal. That is AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to DA. That is A you think. Say A. Say A. So in right triangle, BCD you take the BCD. By Pythagoras theorem. BD square equal to BD square is equal to BC square plus what? CD square. That is A square plus A square. That is 2A square. But we need BD taking square root. Root 2A. BD is root 2A. Take it as 1. BD is root 2A. Now in exercise 6.1, exercise 6.1, you have studied all the equilateral triangles are similar. Clear? Since all the equilateral triangles are similar,
similar. Therefore, triangle QBC similar to triangle PBD or PDB. Anyway, you can write. Clear? Because equilateral triangle only. Understand? So there, when they are similar, then area of this by theorem, use that theorem researcher. By theorem, how you can write area of QBC by area of PDB. Area of PDB is equal to, you take base of this triangle is BC by base of this triangle is BD the whole square. So how to take here necessary corresponding sides? Here we are taking the BC means then BD you have to take, right? Now already you know what is BD, root 2 A. BD is root 2 A. BC is A, right? Root 2 A. You replace it. So cut it. That is by 1 you write here. So that is nothing but here 1. Okay, numerator 1 is there. 1 square is 1. Root 2 square is 2. Root 2 square is 2. Okay, now on the left hand side you have area of QBC by area of PDB. Therefore, this you cross multiply. This one you cross multiply. Okay. Therefore, area of QBC is equal to half into area of PDB. Hence proved. Okay, so easily we can prove this. So like this same type of problem, I will give it as homework. You do the homework problem for better practice.